Now, 800-CHAB presents Ask the Expert. Here's Rob Carney.
With Greg Marcinek, our friend from Heritage Insurance, our insurance expert from Heritage Insurance in downtown Moose Jaw. Once again, Greg, we've seen it happening again, despite the fact we warn our listeners all the time. Break and enters. In fact, they're not even breaking and entering. They're stealing garage door openers and getting in real easy.
That's right, Rob. I know we talked about this not that long ago, just a couple of weeks ago, and people are becoming more and more brazen. I just want to make sure that people lock their front door and lock their vehicle, because these thefts are happening midday on a Sunday afternoon. There's lots of people out. The people are out back. They just check your vehicle, pop the door. If it's open, they grab at your garage door opener and poof, they're off. And they'll come at 2 or 3 in the morning, steal your vehicle, steal whatever. A lot of people don't keep your keys in your garage or in your vehicle and keep that door locked between the garage and your house as well. So, because we've had a couple of claims now like that, and I just want to reiterate that. The other thing that I wanted to talk about is the fact that severe weather is coming, and along with severe weather comes tornadoes, power outages. You just never know when an emergency is going to happen. And you should always have a basic emergency kit set aside. And what you should have is one of those little portable suitcases with wheels on it so that it's easy to carry, or whether it's in a backpack so it's readily available and easy to get out of the house in the event of an emergency. You want to have at least 2 liters of water per person per day. And usually smaller bottles can be carried, or a bigger one. As well, you want food that won't spoil, such as canned food, energy bars, dried foods. And again, if you do have a kit, remember to replace that in the water at least once a year. You want a manual can opener. Definitely flashlights and batteries are a great thing. Battery-powered radio or a wind-up radio, one or the other, along with extra batteries, and as well extra battery or extra battery power for your cell phone. A first aid kit is a must. And any special needs items, if you have any prescription medications, infant formula, or equipment for people with disabilities, you want to have that there. As well, I recommend that you have extra keys for both your car and your house packed in there in the event something does happen and you don't have access to it. Another thing a lot of people don't carry these days is some cash. You should have some extra cash, because I tell you, if power goes down, you've got no ATMs, no debit machines. I know in Toronto, I had a buddy when the power went out there for a week. Fortunately for him, he had about $400 cash. He said it was like gold when he was out there, and it allowed them to eat and, you know, basically survive. And the next thing to do is to have an emergency plan, which includes that you have contacts for in town and out of town and what you're going to do in the event of an emergency. So just take the time to put these things together. You know, it doesn't take too long, and you're prepared in the event something may happen.
And we can find a list of those things to put in the emergency kit online, sir.
That's correct. NoHassleInsurance.ca, or come on down the corner of Fairford and First and talk to any of our fine people here.
This has been Ask the Expert on 800-CHAB.